Hello everyone, this is Mohammad Mazharul Haq of ISL Engineering College and welcome back to today's class of Control System. And today's topic is Analysis of Discrete Data Systems. So let's start now. First of all, we should map the S plane and the Z plane. Mapping the guidelines are provided here. All the points in left of S plane corresponds to points inside the unit circle in Z plane. Now, second thing is all the points in right half of the S plane correspond to the points outside the unit circle. And the points on J omega axis in the S plane correspond to the points on the unit circle Z is equal to 1 in the Z plane. So these three guidelines are very important, where normally when you draw a root locus or any graph where you are using S plane, the left half of the S plane corresponds, left half of S plane corresponds to the points inside unit circle, and right half of S plane corresponds to the points outside the unit circle. So points on J omega axis in S plane corresponds to the points on the unit circle of equation mod Z is equal to 1 in Z plane. So by this we can understand as to students that Z plane is a unit circle as well as S plane is a, just it is a X axis and Y axis. So S is equal to J omega, in the same way Z is equal to e power ts, and you can write e power j omega t, where the magnitude is equals to 1. Now mapping between the S plane and Z plane, we will now constant damping loci we will see here. S is equal to sigma plus j omega of a transfer function and S domain. It determines the damping factor which represents the rate of rise or decay of the time response of the system. The large sigma represents small time constant and the faster decay or rise and vice versa. The loci in the left of S plane vertical line parallel to j omega axis denotes the positive damping since the system is stable. The loci in the right half of S plane denotes negative damping. So coming here, the constant damping loci is Z plane or concentric circles with center at Z is equals to 0. And the negative damping loci maps to circle with radii greater than 1. And positive damping loci map to circle less than 1. So radii, if it is less than 1, then it is positive damping. If the negative damping is there, the radii is greater than 1. And if it is the loci is in the right half S plane, it is negative damping. In the similar way, we have compared here mapping between the S plane and Z plane. Okay. If you see here, constant frequency loci, these are horizontal lines in S plane parallel to the real axis. Corresponding to Z transforms, Z is equals to e power ts, that is equals to e power j omega t. If you see this diagram here, S plane corresponds to j omega n, that is minus j omega n here, and j omega n positive real axis, positive complex axis, and this is positive complex axis of j omega 2. Now if you come here, Z is equal to e power ts is a circle here, and where omega 1t and omega 2t and j omega 2t are being shown here in the circle, like real and imaginary parts here. So if you come here, constant damping ratio loci, if determinant is the damping ratio, S is equal to minus zeta omega n plus or minus j omega n into square root of 1 minus zeta square, where it is written as minus omega tan beta plus or minus j omega. The same thing in the Z transform is equal to e power t into minus omega tan beta plus j omega. That is equal to e power minus 2 pi omega tan beta by omega s at an angle of 2 pi omega by omega s. Now mapping between the S plane and Z plane, the constant frequency loci, these are horizontal lines in S plane parallel to the real axis. Now corresponding the Z transform, Z is equal to e power ts, that is equal to e power j omega. So the similar way, constant damping ratio loci is given by Z is equals to e power minus 2 pi omega tan beta by omega s at an angle of 2 pi omega by omega s. Now we will talk about the stability analysis of discrete time systems. As we know that stability of the continuous time systems are classified by some finding or some poles at the left of the S plane like that. In a similar way, we have the stability analysis of the discrete time system for the Z plane also, or Z plane we have some rules that will be followed for the unit circle, that is the pole should be on the circle and outside the circle or inside the circle will be defining the stability of the system. An initially relaxed, all the initial conditions of system are zero and the system is said to be Bibo stable, that means bounded input and bounded output stable. So if the systems are having bounded input and bounded output, then it is also said to be a bounded system, stability system. However, the stability of the following closed loop system is classified But depending upon the equation, C of z by R of z is equal to G of z by 1 plus G into H of z. Now this can be determined from the location of the closed loop poles in z plane, which are the roots of the characteristic equation 1 plus G into H of z is equals to 0. For finding out the characteristic equation 1 plus G into H of z is equals to 0, now we will transform this particular equation and find out the values of the characteristic equation. So find out the characteristic equation values, what you have to do is 1 plus G into H of z is equals to 0. For this to 1 plus G into H of z is equals to 0, we have some conditions that are to be followed, and these conditions are: for the system to be stable, the closed loop poles or the roots of the characteristic equation must lie within the unit circle in the z plane. As we know, there is a z plane. In the z plane has a circle, and in this circle the system should have the loop poles must lie within the unit circle, the system to be stable. Otherwise the system would be unstable. If a simple pole lies at moderate is equals to 1, the system becomes marginally stable. Similarly, if a pair of complex conjugate poles lie on z is equal to 1 circle, the system is marginally stable. Multiple poles on unit circle make the system unstable. It is an important point to note that if you are having multiple poles and repeated poles on unit circle, it may make the system very unstable. So for example, we will take a block diagram here having the g of s value as k and into 1 minus e power minus s by s and 1 by s into s plus 1. So finding out g of z into 1 minus e power minus s by s into 1 by s into s plus 1, where k is equal to 1. So we are not writing the k value as 1 here, just we are multiplying these two things. So z of red transform of these values gives you 1 minus z inverse into z of 1 by s square into s plus 1. So if you write this c of z by e of z, that is equal to z minus 1 by z into z by z minus 1 whole square minus 1 minus e power minus 1 by z minus 1 into z minus e power minus 1. After getting this c of z by e of z, now what you have to do here is you have to just make these values substituted here, that is z minus 0.36, e inverse is 0.368 minus 0.632 z plus 0.632. After substituting these values, what you get here is you are getting the g of z is equals to 0.368 z plus 0.264 divided by z minus 1 into z minus 0.368. Like we are finding out these g of z by c of z by e of z, we will now prove the stability of the system. How to prove the stability of the system? Now after getting the characteristic equation, we have to take 1 plus g of z is equals to 0. Now the characteristic equation directly will be given, or else we have to find out the characteristic equation from the block diagram. Z minus 1 into z minus 0.368 plus 0.368 z plus 0.264 is equal to 0 is the characteristic equation. Now we will do it in a quadratic expression form. After multiplying this, we get a quadratic equation form, that is z square minus z plus 0.632 is equal to 0. Therefore the complex roots are there, z1 is equal to 0.5 plus 0.618j and z2 is equal to 0.5 minus 0.618j. From this quadratic equation, the roots are z1 and z2. After getting the roots z1 and z2, we see that z1 and z2 are magnitudally same. Magnitude of both are same, that is z1 is equal to z2, modulus of z1 is equal to modulus of z2 as shown in the cursor here. So if it is z1 is equal to z2, if it is less than 1, the magnitude value 0.5 square plus 0.618 whole square, if it is less than 1, then the system is stable. If it is not less than 1, the system is unstable for this stability criteria. Now the stability tests are many applied to the characteristic equation. We are studying now about the Jury stability test and also Raoult stability test. So already we have studied about the Raoult stability test, now studying about the Jury stability test here. So Jury stability test has the equation P of z is equal to a0 into z power n plus a1 into z power n minus 1 plus an minus 1 into z plus an, where a0 is greater than 0. So for this is the main equation that is written, that is a general form of the expression actually, where a0, a1, an minus 1 are the coefficients while seeing the cursor here. Now we make rows 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 as the row, and here z0, z1, z2, z3, z cube, z4, 4 are the variables. Now the coefficients are also written in the order. First row it is a power n, a0, b power n minus 1, b0, b1, and a power n minus 1, a power n minus 2, a1 and a2, like that we are writing this particular things as written in the particular Raoult stability criteria. We are writing this table and we are finding the values of bk and ck values and qk values by substituting the value of k. Or we can say that n minus 1, n minus 2 are substituted the respective values, and finding out the determinant, we will be finding out the remaining values here bk and ck and qk by following this Raoult stability criteria rule only. Now, while writing these equations, we have to write this equation. The system will be stable if a modulus of an, this first row and first column element, modulus of an is less than a naught. If p of z, that is mod at z is equal to 1, should be greater than 0. What is p of z? The general expression form, that should be greater than 0 always. If all the terms gets cancelled and it is equal to 0, then the system will be unstable. And third condition is p of z is at z is equal to minus 1 should be greater than 0 for n even, and p of z at z is equal to minus 1 less than 0 for n is equals to odd. So we are having three different criteria, that is less than an should be less than a0, an modulus of an, and p of z at z is equal to 1 should be greater than 0, and p of z at z is equal to minus 1 should be greater than 0 for n even, and p of z at z is equal to minus 1 should be less than 0 for n is odd. And the fourth condition is modulus of bn minus 1 should be greater than b0 and cn minus 2 greater than c0. Now we will have an example here. P of z is equals to z power 4 minus 1.2 z cube plus 0.07 z square plus 0.3 z minus 0.08 is equals to 0. Now here a0 is equals to 1, a1 is equal to minus 1.2 and a2 is equal to 0.07, a3 is equals to, what is a3 here? 0.3. a4 is minus 0.08. Now first step, an should be less than a0. Modulus of an, what is modulus of an here? That is positive value 0.08. Less than a0. a0 is equals to 1. So it is less than a0. So first condition is satisfied. Next, p of z is equals to 1 greater than 0. P of 1 is equals to 1 minus 1.2. Substitute here the value of 1. Then what we get here is 1 minus 1.2 plus 0.07 plus 0.3 minus 0.08 is equal to 0.09, which is also greater than 0. So the second step is also satisfied. Whatever the jury stability test has the conditions, we are satisfying from first point as well as in second point also. Now the third point is p of z mod z, z is equals to minus 1 should be greater than 0 for n even, and p of z mod z, z is equal to minus 1 is less than 0 for n is equals to odd. Now we will see this equation. So it is also satisfying. Why? Because for minus 1 it is greater than 0 and for minus 1 it is less than 0. So both the all the conditions are satisfied here. So if you see b3, we are writing an, a0, an here. So it is determinant, after determinant minus 0.09936 we get. And b2 is equals to minus 0.08 into 0.3 plus 1.2. That is, we are making these determinant an, a3 minus a1, a0. So 1.176 we get the value here. So b1 is equals to some value, that is minus 0.0756, b0 minus 0.204, c2 is equal to 0.946 and c0 is equal to 0.315. So all these should be greater than 0. So these conditions have been satisfied, and the jury stability test we are making by these conditions, we said that the system is stable. Now one more example, if you take here, p of z is equal to z cube minus 1.3 z square minus 0.08 z plus 0.24 is equal to 0. So the similar way what we have done in the previous problem, we will start doing this one. We will find out a0 is equal to 1 and a1 is equal to minus 1.3 and a2 is equal to minus 0.08, and we write a3 is equal to 0.24. If you see a3 is equal to 0.24, that is less than a0 is equals to 1. If p1 is equals to 1 minus 1.3 minus 0.08 plus 0.24, that is we get minus 0.14. Here the value is negative. The previous problem the value was positive, and here p of 1 is equal to negative value, so it is less than 0 and the system is unstable. So it is simple thing here to find out the stability by just placing the values in the as the coefficients, as z is equal to 1 if you keep here and find out the value that is less than 0 or greater than 0, we can find that the system is stable or unstable. Now p of 1 is equal to 0 or p of minus 1 is equal to 0 indicates the presence of root on the unit circle, and in that case system can the most become marginally stable if rest of the conditions are satisfied. So here the point is p of 1 is equal to 0 or p of minus 1 is equal to 0 indicates the presence of root on the unit circle. So on the unit circle means always it is marginally stable. So we write the equation here, g of z is equal to k into 0.368 z plus 0.264 divided by z minus 1 into z minus 0.368, that is c of z by r of z is equal to k into 0.368 z plus 0.264 divided by z square plus 0.368 k minus 1.368 z plus 0.368 plus 0.264 k. Now here we have got all the values and we are writing the characteristic equation for that, and the characteristic equation can be represented by z square coefficient, z square term and z term, as well as the constant term. Here the constant term is 0.368 plus 0.264 k as it is shown in the cursor here. Okay, now the characteristic equation given here is equals to 0, we are saying p of z is equal to 0. Now all the points we have to see whether it is satisfying the value or not. So a2 is less than a naught, first point, a2 is less than a naught, we will see that. So if you do modulus of a2, 0.368 plus 0.264 k, what we get is we get the value of k lying between 2.39 and k minus 5.18. So now the second point is p of 1 greater than 0. P of 1 is equal to 1 plus 0.368 k minus 1.368 plus 0.368 plus 0.264 k, where the value of k is greater than 0. So here we see what are the conditions satisfying or not satisfying. P of minus 1 is greater than 0 since n is equal to 2 and it is even. So the k value lies between 0 and 2.39. If k is equal to 2.39, the system becomes critically stable. Okay, the characteristic equation is given by z square minus 0.49 z plus 1, that is z is 0.244 plus or minus j 0.97, because if 2.39 is given, it is critically stable. So we are taking here minus 0.49 z. So the singular cases, when sum or all elements of a row in jury table are 0, as you have studied in the Routh-Leibniz stability criteria, that if any element is 0, what should we do then? In the similar way, the singular cases, when sum or all the elements of a row in a jury table are 0, the tabulation ends. And this situation is referred to as a singular case. What is a singular case? Where the elements of a row in a jury table are 0. This situation is referred to as singular case, and it can be avoided by expanding or contracting unit circle infinitesimally by an amount epsilon. So we see that z1 is equal to 1 plus epsilon into z. That is nothing but expanding or contracting the unit circle. So for the jury stability test, we have to do this expanding or contracting by z1 is equal to 1 plus epsilon into z. The difference between the number of zeros found inside or outside the unit circle when the unit circle is expanded or contracted is the number of zeros on the unit circle. So we should note this point. The difference between the number of zeros found inside or outside the unit circle when the unit circle is expanded or contracted is the number of zeros on the unit circle. Even the contraction or expansion has occurred, the zeros will be there, and the zeros lying inside or outside unit circle makes a difference here. Now seeing this one, the example p of z is equal to z cube plus 0.25 z square plus z plus 0.25 is equal to 0, we have a0 is equals to 1, a1 is equal to 0.25, and a2 is equals to 1, a3 is equal to 0.25. We have modulus of an is equals to modulus of a3. That is equal to 0.25 less than a0 is equal to 1. First condition is satisfied because the value is less than, that is less than 0. a0 is how much? a0 is 1. 0.25 is less than 1, though the first condition is satisfied. Now p of 1 is equals to 1 plus 0.25 plus 1 plus 0.25, that is equal to 2.5, hence the second condition is also satisfied. And p of minus 1, substitute the minus 1 value here. If you substitute the minus 1 value, minus 1 whole cube, it is minus 1 plus 0.25 whole square, minus 1 whole square, it is only 0.25, minus 1 plus 0.25, it is equals to minus 1.5, that is less than 0. And third condition is also satisfied. Now we will find b2 and b1. As there in the table, we have to find out the b2 and b1 values. So b2 is minus 0.9375 and b1 is equals to a3, a1, a0, a2, and that is 0.25 minus 0.25 is equal to 0. Hence the roots lie on the unit circle. Roots lie on the unit circle. Now what we do is we go to the example where we have here epsilon, 1 plus epsilon into z, so for contracting or expanding the circle. So for this we write the equation by replacing z by 1 plus epsilon into z. So everywhere here we will write 1 plus 3 into epsilon into z cube, 1 plus 2 into epsilon, and 1 plus e into z here plus 0.25. So note this equation. This equation may be helpful for us to find out the Jury stability test by replacing the value 1 plus epsilon into z. Already we have discussed that why we are replacing z by 1 plus epsilon into z. Why? Because if any of the terms is 0, we can replace it by 1 plus epsilon into z. After writing the Jury table, these values are written in the Jury table. And after writing the Jury table, we find b2 and b0. When epsilon is greater than 0, and what we see here is the range will be specified for the epsilon, and b2 greater than b0. So after writing this, the test of the stability of the polynomial should be written of f of z is equal to z power 5 plus 2.6 z power 4 minus 0.56 z cube minus 2.05 z square plus 0.077 z plus 0.35 is equal to 0. We compute the entries of Jury table using the coefficients of polynomial. Now writing the coefficients of the polynomial, this is the row as well as this is the z square, z power 0, z1, z square and z cube and z power 4, z power 5 are the variables. Now we write the values of the this Jury table representing this characteristic equation. After writing this characteristic equation, we see that the conditions are greater than 0, and second condition that should be less than 0, and the third condition p of minus 1, and the fourth condition that is and the fifth condition and the sixth condition, whatever we have studied now, should be checked for the this particular polynomial. Now the conditions 2 and 5, 6 are violated here. 2, 5 and 6. Second equation, it is less than 0. So it is a violated one. Fifth equation, it is the less than 0.0770 is less than 0.5151 is a violated one. And sixth is also a violated condition. So these conditions are violated and the polynomial has roots on or outside the unit circle. In fact, the polynomial now can be factorized as z minus 0.7 into z minus 0.5 into z plus 0.5 into z plus 0.8 into z plus 2.5 is equal to 0, and has a root that is minus 2.5 outside the unit circle, because this z is equal to minus 2.5 is only value which is having greater than 0, which is greater than 0 and which is minus 2.5 value. Note that the number of conditions valid is not equal to the number of roots outside the unit circle, and that condition 2 is sufficient to conclude the instability of f of z. Okay. So for this, we can by this Jury stability test, we can go through all these points of first point to seventh point here and note down these particular points so that the stability can be analyzed. So for discrete time systems, the jury stability test holds good by knowing that the system is marginally stable or unstable or stable. So with this, I have covered examples on jury stability test, as well as I have explained about the analysis of the discrete time system stability here. And in the next class, we will talk about the next topic. Thank you.